Welcome students to the fifth part of Operational Amplifier series. Myself, Dr. Kirti Vyas, and we are going to discuss about the subject analog circuits, and the topic is operational amplifiers. Let's get started with the topic. We have already discussed about op-amp, its various parameters, its utility, its importance. Now, today we are going to discuss about closed loop amplifier. Now, first of all, since the amplifier is closed loop, that means obviously from the output towards the input we are having a connection in form of a feedback. Now, what is the use of this feedback? The gain of the amplifier can be controlled if the feedback is introduced in the circuit. That is, an output signal is fed back to the input directly or via some network. Now, if negative feedback is applied, that means if the signal feedback is of opposite or out of phase by 180 degree with respect to input signal, the feedback is called negative feedback. An amplifier with negative feedback has self-correcting ability of change in output voltage caused by change in environmental condition. This is also known as degenerative feedback because it reduces the output voltage and in turn reduces the voltage gain. Now, we should also understand what is the importance of negative feedback. The negative feedback stabilizes the gain, increases the bandwidth, and changes the input-output resistance. Other benefits are reduced distortion and reduced offset output voltage. It also reduces the effect of temperature and supply voltage variation on the output of an op-amp. Now, the positive feedback. If the signal is fed in phase with the input signal, the feedback is known as positive feedback. In positive feedback, the feedback signal aids the input signal, that is, these are additive in nature and get added up. This is also known as regenerative feedback. Why we require positive feedback is to construct certain kind of circuit, that is oscillator circuit, which have the capability to generate the waveform. A closed loop amplifier can be represented by two blocks, one for an op amp and other for a feedback circuit. There are four following ways to connect these blocks. Basically, these are voltage series, voltage shunt, current series and current shunt. But in case of op-amp, what matters is the voltage series feedback and second one is a voltage shunt feedback. These are quite important. So we are going to discuss about these particular circuits. As you can see, the circuit in the left talks about voltage series feedback. Here you can see why it is known as voltage series, because the voltage term is denoting about the output port, that from output port a voltage sample has been taken and fed as a series in the input. Hence it makes a voltage series. Next circuit is about voltage shunt. Now at the output the voltage is taken across the load resistor and at the input it is mixed as a shunt circuit to the input, and hence the topology is known as voltage shunt feedback. Now voltage series feedback, one of the example is shown in this particular slide. It is also known as non-inverting voltage feedback circuit. Since you can see the signal is only given to the non-inverting terminal and the feedback network is connected to the inverting terminal with resistance RF. With this type of feedback, the input signal drives the non-inverting input of an amplifier, and the fraction of the output voltage is then fed back to the inverting input. The op-amp is represented by its symbol, including its large signal voltage gain AD, or simply a A, which is denoted on the right-hand side of the figure. And the feedback circuit is composed of two resistors, as you can see, which are connected to the inverting terminal, and these are R1 and RF. Why RF has been chosen? R stands for the resistor and F for the feedback. That is, this resistance has been chosen to give the feedback from the output towards the input. Now, this particular circuit I have tried to draw in each and every slide so that we don't have to move to our previous slide. Now, the open loop voltage gain AD is equals to V output upon the differential input voltage. Now, the closed loop gain is denoted by A is gain, CL is closed loop gain, is equals to V naught upon VIN. And the feedback circuit is output of a feedback circuit, that is VF, upon input of the feedback circuit, that is VO. And this particular feedback circuit gain B is represented by R1 upon R1 plus RF. The differential voltage input VD is equals to VIN minus VF. The feedback voltage always opposes the input voltage or is out of phase by 180 degree with respect to input voltage, hence feedback is said to be negative. The closed loop voltage gain is given by A CL for closed loop is equals to VO upon VIN. Here VO is equals to A into V1 minus V2 is equals to A V1. For V1 we are given V input, that is why V1 has been replaced by VIN minus VF. Since the output V2 is equals to the feedback voltage VF, so we are having is equals to VO is equals to A VIN minus feedback gain beta into V0, and hence we conclude that V0 by VIN equals to A upon 1 plus A beta or B. This product A into B is known as loop gain. The gain loop is very large such that A beta is greater than 1. If this is so, we can neglect the unity and we can write 1 plus AB is equals to almost AB, and VO upon VIN comes out to be 1 by beta. This shows that overall voltage gain of the circuit equals the reciprocal of B, the feedback gain. It means that the voltage loop gain is no longer dependent on the gain of the op-amp, but it depends on the feedback of the voltage divider circuit, which is used in form of the resistance R1 and RF. So, rewriting this particular value of B, we have the V0 by V in V output by V input is equals to 1 plus RF by R1. Hence, this gives us an idea how this particular closed loop op-amp circuit can utilize to amplify the signal. The feedback gain B can be precisely controlled and is independent of the amplifier. Physically, what is happening in the circuit? The gain you can see is approximately constant, even though the differential voltage gain may change. Suppose A green increases for some reason, maybe a change of temperature, then the input voltage will also try to increase. This means that more voltage is fed back to the inverting input, causing VD voltage to decrease. This almost completely offset the attempted increase in output voltage. This was the case when gain was increasing. If say A decreases, then the output voltage decreases. It reduces the feedback voltage Vf and hence Vd voltage increases. Thus, the output voltage increases almost to the same level. The different input voltage is ideally zero. Again, considering the voltage equation, which is equals to output voltage Vo equals to Ad into Vd, we can write Vd is equals to Vo upon Ad. And since Ad is quite large, ideally it is infinity, but practically it is not so. So if Ad is quite large, then our Vd will be almost equals to zero, and we will see that V1 is equals to V2, which is the ideal case. In this says that the voltage at the non-inverting terminal of an op-amp is approximately equal to that of the inverting input terminal, provided Ad is very large. This concept is useful in the analysis of the closed loop op-amp circuit. For example, ideal closed loop voltage again can be obtained using the results. So we have this particular way we can write: if V1 equals to Vin, V2 equals to Vf, V is equals to R1 upon R1 plus Rf upon into V0, and since V1 is equals to V2, in this case we already discussed, then we can write V input is equals to V2, which is equals to R1 Vo upon R1 plus Rf, and hence Vo equals to 1 plus R1 by Rf into V in. Now, the closed loop amplifier input resistance with feedback. Now, the figure 3 shows a voltage series feedback with the op-amp equivalent circuit. Here you can see the input has been given to the non-inverting terminal in the form of source Vin, and the RF is connected to the inverting terminal, and this particular voltage divider circuit has been used for the feedback. In this circuit, Ri is the input resistance that refers for open loop of a op-amp, and Rif is the input resistance of the feedback amplifier. So the input resistance with feedback will be equals to Vin upon Iin, that is input current going inside the input port, which will be equals to Vin equals to Vd plus Vf. This will be equals to Vd plus Vf can be written in the form of BV0, and V0 can be written as A times of Vd. Hence, at last we are having Vin by In equals to Ri into 1 plus A beta, which is our Rif value. So we have seen, along with the feedback, the input resistance increases by a factor of 1 plus A beta. Since A beta is larger than 1, which means Rif is much larger than Ri. Thus, Rif approaches infinity, and therefore this amplifier approximates an ideal voltage amplifier. Now, the output resistance with feedback. The output resistance is a resistance determined looking back into the feedback amplifier from the output. To find the output resistance with feedback Rf, the input Vin is reduced to zero. External voltage V0 is applied as shown in the figure 4. The output resistance Rof is defined as Vo upon Io, which can be found by Io equals to Ia plus Ib. Applying the KVL at the output loop, we will have the value of Io and in terms of the voltage Vo, and we will derive Rof which is output resistance at the feedback, is equals to VO upon IO is equals to RO upon 1 plus A beta. This shows that the output resistance of a voltage series feedback amplifier is 1 upon 1 plus A beta times the output resistance RO of a op-amp. It is very small because 1 plus A beta is very large. It approximates to 0 for an ideal voltage amplifier. Now we will talk about voltage follower. The voltage follower is a type of circuit which follows the input voltage. The lowest gain that can be obtained from a non-inverting amplifier with feedback is unity. When non-inverting amplifier gives unity gain, it is known as voltage follower because the output voltage is equal to the input voltage and in phase with the input voltage. In other words, the output voltage follows the input voltage. To obtain the voltage amplifier, R1 is open circuited and RF, which we discussed in an earlier circuit, is shorted in a negative feedback amplifier. The resultant circuit is shown in the figure V. Here, according to this circuit, the Vout is equals to A into Vd will be equals to A into difference of input V1 minus V2. V1 is Vin, V2 is Vout since it is directly connected to Vout. V1 is equals to V2 if A is greater than 1 and Vout is equals to Vin. The feedback of the gain of the feedback circuit B is unity. Therefore, AF is equals to 1 upon B is unity and hence confirming the voltage follower. Thank you for listening to this lecture. Next, we will move about in next lecture, we will discuss about more of the operational amplifiers. Thank you.